the worst nightmare you could ever imagine.
We just saw an airplane crash.
A Boeing 737 nosedived into a wooded ravine in Pennsylvania.
It looked like a USAir jet. It went straight down.
All 132 people on board died.
USAir 427, Pittsburgh. USAir 427, Pittsburgh. USAir 427, radar contact lost.
7:03 p.m., September 8, 1994. Urgent calls from the control tower at Pittsburgh International would go unanswered. USAir Flight 427 en route to Pittsburgh was gone. The Boeing 737 veered left, rolled, then nosedived into a spiral that ended in a deadly plunge to the earth below. All 132 people on board died.
One of the first responders to the scene was volunteer firefighter John Sherback.
I'm standing on a hillside, looking around at what's left of a commercial airliner. Just everywhere. It's just in any direction you went, the farther you went, the worse it got, until you finally stopped and turned around and looked and realized you were standing in the middle of the worst nightmare you could ever imagine.
A man who owns property where Flight 427 crashed says the disaster was not fit for eyes to see.
Workers on the recovery team continued the emotionally draining process of recovering victims' remains and wreckage.
We're having a lot of hardcore men who are breaking down. They're crying on the scene. It's tough. It's getting tough.
The FAA started an immediate investigation to find out what went wrong.
Police escorts protect the precious parts. 35% to 40% of them had been removed by trucks from the crash site. They're then taken here to this guarded airplane hangar. Inside, NTSB investigators will reassemble the crash site.
By January of 95, the NTSB began public hearings in Pittsburgh on the crash of Flight 427. Although there was no conclusive evidence of what caused Flight 427 to go down, speculation began about a malfunctioning rudder. September 8, 1995, the first anniversary of the crash. Hundreds of people gathered in a soccer field near the crash site to remember and pray. At this Sewickley Cemetery, victims' family members and dozens of others paid their respects. They laid wreaths, wept, and reflected on the names of all 132 engraved in the stone memorial.
Something we all have to go through within ourselves, you know. Even though we have each other, we all have to work it through in our own way.
The government, the airline, and manufacturer all argued over what and who was to blame. More than 4 years later, the longest aviation investigation in history finally ended. The crash was blamed on the rudder. The NTSB said it likely went the opposite direction because its power control unit, called a servo valve, jammed.
You see the pilot push down on the right rudder pedal, but instead the left rudder pedal responds. This animation shows Flight 427 responding to the rudder reversal. The plane plunged into a downward spiral and crashed.
This forced a $1 billion fix from manufacturers to make air travel safer. Pilots were also ordered to undergo additional training.
One expert said no other crash investigation had so much national impact as that of Flight 427 that went down in our region. In fact, after that, so much changed for everyone when it comes to airline travel.
You know, people talk about over the hill. It makes it sound like you do this climb and then you get to do some coasting. Life's not like that. It's constant zigzags stuff. I believe that we have a say-so whether or not we want to stay in those valleys.
Unfortunately, Flight 427 is always going to be a part of Pittsburgh's history. And seeing people who just really care and remember is all that, as a family member, you want.